regarding fetch and execution cycle. You follow? So may nilagay ako doon because I've taken some other sources, no? Bakit nawala yung ating ano? Maybe it's in another side. So the fetch cycle particularly has three phases. Spera is here. The fetch phase, no, kasi hindi masyadong klaro yung ano, yung the way it was explained in the book, no. So hindi masyadong clear, no. So I have added supplemental information in our ano, additional information in our website, in our Daigler site. Okay. To explain in detail what happens when the an instruction is fetched. Okay. Load and store lang i-discuss. Wait, did we have ano? Did we discuss ano? Oh, ito, no? Okay. So during a fetch, there are three, the fetch cycle has three main phases. The address phase, where the address is being generated from the program counter. Okay. So particularly, this is copied to the memory address register. What is shown here is a direct copy of the program counter into the memory into the instruction register. No, it's not directly, no. It's done in three steps. Now, according to the book, there's one step, but the actual, no, execution of the fetch phase is in three steps. First, it is called the address phase. So the MA receives the PC, okay? And then the PC receives PC plus one, which is a second phase, no? This is called the increment phase. Now, in our book, the increment phase is the third step, but it doesn't matter. Do you follow? In most other books, the increment phase is the second step. Okay, so in our book, it's the third, but it doesn't matter, no? As long as the PC is incremented by one before the execution, okay? So, and then IR receives the memory address by the memory phase. So that's why whatever 1940, which is load 1940, is added into the IR. That's how it happened. First, the memory is copied to the MAR, and then the PC is incremented by one, so it's now here, no? Do you follow? Okay. And then, so now we have 1940. Remember, one is our code for load, no? And five is our code for add, and two is our code for store, okay? So what this means is we load 940. So what is loaded here is first the instruction. Okay. So before the instruction is executed, no, it is first loaded into the IR using three of these steps. Now, how is the load executed? Now, it will involve the memory address register. First, the MA receives the address part of the IR. Do you follow, everyone? No? So hindi pinakita kasi dito sa libro. But first, this is taken in two steps. The MAR receives the memory address of the IR. The memory address is 940. Okay? Okay? Do you follow? And then a memory read is done. Okay? They're on the same, on the same step, no? Pwede ba ito on the same steps? Kasi pa, ang 940 memory is done. Okay? And then, right away, no? The MBR, which is not seen there, will receive the address, the contents of address 940. Okay, itong 940, i-re-read niya, which is 003. And now the MBR is store 003. Okay? During the second step, the value 003 is transferred from the MBR to AC. Okay? So, ganon. Okay? That completes the load execution, fetch and execution. Any questions so far? Okay. So the next value command in memory is 5941. So incidentally, no, the program counter is now 301 because it was incremented during. This is the first command, the second command, and the third command. Do you follow? No. And the program counter is now pointing to 301. So which now is not the where the CPU is now ready to fetch the next instruction. Dito na naka-point ngayon. Okay? So balik na naman tayo sa execution phase. MAR receives PC, okay, which is the address part, no? The address part, MAR receives PC, and PC receives PC plus 1, so nagiging 302 na siya. Okay? And IR receives the contents of memory as addressed by MAR, no? M of MAR. No? So M of MAR is 301. Okay, remember because the MAR receives PC, so it became 301. It reads the memory and then loads it to the IR. So the IR now contains 5941. What does this mean? 5 means add. 941 means the address to be added. You follow? So now that completes the fetch of add. Now the other part is to execute add. How do we execute add? So nandito no, the execution of add. Okay. First, it's like a load, no? It will take what is going to be added, which is 2. So MAR receives the, okay? MAR receives the address part of the IR. So the address part of IR is 941, okay? So effectively, MAR receives 941, and the memory read is done, and the memory read is outputted to the MBR. So MBR receives 002. Kasi 002 yung nakalagay sa 941. We follow. This is done in 2 steps, no? 3 steps, no? And then ALU performs the adding of the MBR and AC, okay? Because the accumulator register contains AR, or rather 3, di ba? And then the MBR contains 2, right? Hindi niya nilagay dito ang contents ng MBR. Eh. During the second step, ALU adds MBR, which is 2, and AC, which is 3. Okay? And then during the third step, the ALU receives its result. Okay? So therefore, ALU now becomes 5. Okay? Do you follow? So at what we have now at the AC, okay, AC, by the way, receives the result from the ALU. What we have now is the result from the ALU, which is 5. Any questions so far? So ganun, no? So we're done with the second instruction. We have added 3 and 2. The next is to load it to 941. Kasi ito, 2941, which means whatever the result is, which is 5, will be loaded, will be stored to 941. So before it's stored, we will fetch the next instruction. Now we know that the PC now points to 302 because it was incremented during the previous instruction. Okay. So, balik tayo sa fetch. The fetch is the same. Remember, no? The fetch is the same for all instructions. MAR receives PC. Okay, and PC receives PC plus 1. So, magiging 303 yan. Do you follow? Okay. And then IR receives the memory as addressed by MAR. The address memory is 302. So, ito. Si 302. So, si 302 will now be stored there. I'm sorry, no? Okay. Do you follow? Now, that's the load of store. How is store executed? So, nandito yung execution ng store. First, MAR receives IR, the address part. So, the memory being address is 941. Okay? Okay? So, MAR receives 941. Okay? And then, it's read. Okay? Do you follow? So, MBR receives AC. MBR receives AC. The value of the MBR is also up. This can be done at the same time because this involves 2 different registers. Okay, MAR and MBR. The MAR receives the memory receives the address from the IR. Okay, which is 002. No, 941. 941. And then MBR receives the AC. So itong AC na to, which is 5, is copied to the MBR. And during the third step, rather second step, no, memory address by MAR, which is 941, receives MBR, which is 5. So five now is copied there. Okay. Do you follow? Any questions? So this is a clear illustration which involves the actual set of registers. Next week na lang tayo mag-synchronous, no? Kasi makadagdag na ako ng exercises. I'll figure out the exercises first. Any questions so far? Okay. Okay, that's about program execution. Okay. So program execution is done in two parts, no, two steps. Fetch and execute. The fetch of all instructions are the same. Okay? The fetch of all instructions are the same, but the execution differs from instruction to instruction. No? And the control signal, the set of control signals will be executed uniquely during each step. No? Ito, ma-execute ito. For example, if you have MAR receives PC, the control signals that are enabled are MAR is enabled. MAR is will receive. Okay? So, anong tawag dyan? Load is loaded. And then the PC is enabled. When the PC is enabled, it stores a value to the bus. When the MAR is loaded, it gets a value from the bus. In this, we have increment PC. So, the control signal which is sent is PC, inc PC. No? And then IR is here is loaded. And the memory address register is enabled. Okay, so that when you say a register is enabled, it stores a value to the bus. When a register is loaded, it gets a value from the bus. Okay, if I so these are the control signals. So a unique set of control signals are added in each part of the instruction, in each step of the instruction. Okay, any questions so far? Okay. So let's proceed with this. So if you look at the states, no? These are the states of the CPU, the state diagram of the CPU. Okay. Okay, sandali lang ha. Titingnan ko yung aking I may get lost. So ito yung state diagram of the CPU, no? Okay. The first part, ito first part is where the memory is involved. Okay. So there are two parts, no? It's either the instruction is fetched or an operand is fetched. So tingnan natin saan kung mag-operand tayo. During a load, okay, an operand is fetched. During dito no, sa load ito, an operand is fetched. MAR receives IR register. So this is the state, the part, the states where the memory is used. Now, the lower part is where the CPU is used, no? Do you follow? The ALU is used, the arithmetic logic unit. So at the part when we say instruction is fetched, no, we say we have IR receives MAR. Okay, when an operand is fetched, okay, we see MBR receives M of MA. Ito, no, ito, that happens during a load. Now, when an operand is stored, do you follow? That happens during a store. Okay, we say M receives M of MAR receives MBR. Do you follow? So itong mga states sa taas are memory operations. The states below are ALU and CPU operations. Do you follow? So for example, if you look at the fetch cycle, no? The first part is address calculation. Actually, PC, the setup of the PC, it's called, it's done before, no? The previous instruction, PC receives PC plus one, right? Okay. And after that, we fetch the instruction by IR receives M of MAR. Okay, kasi baligtad yung sa ating book, eh, no? Okay. Inisa na lang niya, no? Instruction fetch, IR receives memory of MAR. So para sa kanya ito, okay, this is the address calculation. How do you calculate the address? MAR receives PC and PC receives PC plus 1. That's the address calculation. After that, the instruction is fetched, no? So it's now in the IR, and now the instruction operation, whatever is the instruction there is decoded. So ito, no? IR is ito ang madidecode, which means IR will be loaded, the MAR will be enabled. Okay? And then during a load, it may proceed to a load or it may proceed to a store, no? So this is the state diagram of that program. Do you follow? No? Now during the load, no? Ito yung execution ng load, we will also calculate the address. Okay, by get, this is the address calculation, no? MAR receives. Okay. So the address being calculated will be stored to the MAR. Okay. The address is calculated by getting the address part of the MAR. So here we are able to calculate that the address is 940. Okay. And then when we say operand is fetched, no? AC receives MB. Ito, no? Dapat pala pangatlo ito. We'll have this as a different step. Kasi the operand is fetched when we say AC receives. Ito na nga yun. AC receives MBR. Okay? The accumulator now is received. Ito na yung state na ito. Okay, but actually the memory reading, no? It's done. The isang step ito. Okay? The reading of the memory into the accumulator. Do you follow? And then a data operation is done, whether it's going to be added or be left alone or not. No? So in case of a load, it's just no data operation is done. Now in case of an add, no, there's an additional operation, which is, okay, ALU adds the MBR and AC. Okay, before, okay, giving the value to the AC. Okay, during a store, okay, we'll have an operand address calculation the same way MAR receives the address part. Okay, okay, and then the actual store, okay, M of MAR receives the MBR. So nandito na yung operand store. Do you follow? So these are the state diagram. This is the state diagram. No? So for example, it may proceed to a data operation. The data operation may be blank. No? And then it goes back to, okay, either, no, operand address calculation for a store or operand address operation for a fetch of the next instruction. Okay? Any questions so far? So the above are memory operations, the below are the ALU, the states below are the ALU and the CPU states. Okay? Any questions so far? Now, we will introduce a new concept. The program execution we have is actually a very simplistic operation. No? Wala tayong IO device. What will happen if you have an IO device, such as we will have keyboards, we will have printers, no, we have mouse, no? Okay. So who will perform the processing of the mouse commands or the keyboard commands? For example, if a key is pressed on the keyboard, so it will be transferred immediately. At in the end, it will be transferred to the MBR. Okay? Yung keyboard na will be transferred to the MBR. Who will transfer the keyboard key from the keyboard to the MBR? Hindi pwedeng ang CPU. Do you follow? Because the CPU has no access to the keyboard. Diba? Hindi niya alam yung keyboard. So what will happen usually when a keyboard is being asked, no? When you ask for an input from a keyboard, no? A different program is executed in memory, no? So nandun yung program sa memory, but the CPU will not process it, no? It will be the input device which will process it. Okay? And when the processing is done, an interrupt signal will be sent by the keyboard to the CPU to tell the CPU that the keyboard has been fetched and is now in the buffer and will be ready from the output port in memory. So ang gagawin ng keyboard kasi is kukunin niya yung byte from the keyboard and place it in memory. Do you follow? And once in memory, the CPU will copy it from the given port address by the keyboard in memory to the MBR. Do you follow? Do you follow? So there's a mechanism by which other modules may interrupt the normal sequence of processing. Why? Because when other modules are able to process, to complete their processing, they must signal the CPU to stop whatever it's doing and address, okay, the data transfer. So there's a book, no, in operating systems by Andrew Tannenbaum explaining that the CPU is like a housewife daw, who is multitasking. While she's cooking, she's going through the recipe book step by step. And then while she was cooking, one of his children got injured and called her attention, okay, to patch a small wound. So ang gagawin daw ng nanay is she will mark the part in the recipe book where she stops and will get another book called the first aid book. Okay? And then she will start, okay, processing, okay, the injury by doing the first aid book step by step. Pagkatapos niya, once she has addressed to the first aid book, we will close the first aid book and go back to the recipe book and find the exact part where she stopped and resume execution from there. So ganun ang explanation ni Andrew Tannenbaum, no? I'm not sure if he's still around, no? But he's a very popular author in operating systems. That he compared the CPU. It's almost correct, no? Kaya lang, the CPU does not process the first aid. No, ang mag-process ng first aid, ibang tao yung mag-process ng first aid. Do you follow? Maybe the child himself will process the first aid and he will call his mother's attention when he's done with the first aid kit so that his mother will close the first aid kit and resume to the recipe book. Ganun dapat ang ano, the more realistic scenario that happens in a CPU. Hindi yung CPU yung mag-address ng first aid kit, okay? Pero more or less, that's how it works, no? So, for example, no, examples of interrupts signals, no, are aside from keyboard interrupts, no, printer interrupts, timer interrupts. Mag-end tayo, no? Do you follow? Once we're cut, we'll just go back, no? I think we will be done in a few minutes, no? Okay. So timer. You know a timer? Malalaman naman natin dito. Everyone, do you know a timer? Diba? Have you opened your desktop? Diba may battery doon na bilog sa loob? It's a clock battery. Because there's a clock inside. Such that even if you set your unplug your desktop, your computer, the clock will keep on ticking and will keep on updating the correct time and date. Okay? Kahit na naka-unplug pa. Have you seen that? Okay? Have you seen the ano, the battery there? The CMOS battery, no? Ang tawag dyan. Okay, binibili mo yan. Ano mangyari pag mawala na yung CMOS? There's a chat, by the way. So may espera. Pag maubos yung battery, you will be out of date on time. Diba? That's why you have to replenish the battery. Oh, i-reset niyo itong clock. Okay, kung mawala, mahurot ang battery. So, that clock itself generates an interrupt signal every time, every now and then. Para pagbago yung date, babaguhin rin ng CPU yung kanyang date and time. Do you follow? So the moment you set your computer on, the timer interrupt already tells the CPU update your clock right away. This is the current date and time. Okay? Do you follow? But aside from that, it will not stop, no? It will not stop telling the CPU, oh, bago na naman yung time. How long and life ng battery, sir? Usually 3 years. 3 years yung sa akin, no? Ang mga laptop walang battery na CMOS battery. Most of the laptops don't have a CMOS battery because they have internal batteries themselves. Meron ba akong CMOS battery dito? Let me find one. Sige lang, next time. Dun sa ano, dun sa isa kong room, marami akong stock na CMOS battery. Kasi mahirap mawala ng CMOS battery. Okay? Ma-out of sync, and it was one of the effects when you lose CMOS battery is mag-reboot yung computer mo bigla in Windows. Do you follow? One of the symptoms of your CMOS battery getting out of power is mag-reboot yung ano, bisag naka-Windows ka, reboot yung CMOS. Kasi mali yung date and time na binibigay niya. Okay? Okay. Although you can correct this by setting your clock to auto sync, pero pag start, ganun pa rin. Mali, no? Kung wala kang internet, mali yung date and time. Okay? Okay. So, timer tick interrupt, no? Now, the timer tick interrupt is used by your operating system in generating your warp yung ano, yung ang tawag diyan screen blanker. Actually, during our college days, we write our own screen blanker in DOS. Na? Program, believe it or not, we write our own screen blanker in DOS. So we write our own screen effects. Nowadays, we can't do that anymore because the timer tick interrupt is no longer accessible in Windows. Okay? Di-mask na yan ng OS. Di mo yan basta-basta ma-access. Kung ma-access mo yan, you use an assembler. Pero that's a dangerous thing to do. So, ang ginagamit namin, we will, every time a keyboard interrupt, what we do is this. Every time a keyboard or mouse interrupt is clicked, we will set our timer. We will create our own counter. Shall we say, we will blank the screen in 2 minutes. So, in 60 seconds, pag walang mangyari sa mouse, if there's nothing happening, there's no interrupt from the mouse and the keyboard, we will increment 1, 2, 3, 4. I think, 1 second is 1,000 ticks. I'm not sure, no? Basta binibilang namin yun. Pagdating ng 60 seconds, now, before the 60 seconds, if a mouse is clicked or moved, and the keyboard or a keyboard key is clicked or pressed, we will reset our timer to zero. Yung sa timer namin, hindi yung timer ng clock, no? Yung counter namin, so balik sa zero. Tapos, after that last clock, last keyboard or mouse activity, mag-start naman siya ng count. Kung marating niya yung limit that we set, we will save the screen. No? There's an area in memory where you can save the screen and the position of the pointer, no, of the keyboard and the mouse. Isi-save namin yun sa screen and then we will play an animation in the screen. Okay? And then when the keyboard key is pressed, what we will do is check if the screen is blank. It's a favorite student program, no? For how many years? For almost a decade, no?
Yung ano gani, yung tita ni ano, ni Harriet,
oh, marunong sila niyan. Yung screen blanker. Okay? Marunong silang gumawa niyan kasi we can still have access, no? We still have a lot of access to the CPU. So, when a keyboard key is pressed, what we'll do is we will check if the screen is blank. If the screen is blank, we will save, we will show the save screen and then we'll reset our timer or our counter to zero. If the screen is not blank, we'll just reset it to zero. So enjoy, no? Enjoy yung program na yun. And then we'll have another, no? We have another program also. I hope I can give you that, no? I'm trying to figure out if we can run DOS, no? A DOS virtual machine in Windows. So that, pero wala na rin kasi tayong IO port ngayon. We wrote a serial port chat. We connect our computers through serial cable and then we do a chat, no? So meron kaming mute in, it's an application in operating systems, yung mutation, where if one is typing, the other one is listening, no? Ganun, no? It all has to do with of course we have to use interrupt signals, no? From ports, from timers, no? From keyboards, no? Ma-explore mo talaga, you will understand this process by heart, no? Ngayon wala na tayong magawa, no? We can only read the concepts in the books. We can never program them anymore. I hope we can find, no? Ang hinahanap ko kasi yung debugger ng DOS. Nawala na talaga yung debugger ng DOS because it's an 8-bit debugger. Okay, so hindi natin matrace yung ating ano, machine language program. No? So, an interrupt signal can also come from an input and output device. For example, a printer, no? Or a keyboard, no? Or a disk, or a hard disk. When you send a command to copy or to get a data from the hard disk will do the processing itself. And then once it's done, it will place the data on an assigned area in memory and will generate an interrupt. Ganon din yung printer. Pag sinabi mong mayroon kang ipaprint, it will just do the printing and when it's done, it will send an interrupt. A memory failure will also send an interrupt. No? Okay. Anyway, we will discuss interrupt signals na lang next meeting, okay? Kasi mahaba ito eh. Do you follow? For the moment, you know what an interrupt is. It is a signal coming from a third-party device telling the CPU to stop. Okay? Stop. Okay? So maybe next week na tayo maka-start ng synchronous, no? Asynchronous meetings where I could give you exercises, readings, and then we will discuss the exercises at the end. Okay? Any questions? Less than 1 minute. So we'll end the session na lang, no? Okay? Kasi 1 minute, we'll be off, okay? Hindi na tayo makabalik because we'll be running out of time anyway, no? Thanks everyone for coming, no? Next meeting, we will discuss the concept of interrupts. Dito muna tayo ha, sa Zoom. Saka na tayo maglipat pag meron na akong magandang ano. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Goodbye, sir.
Bye, sir. Bye, sir.